Godfather of the Cosmos? That's a pretty arrogant name for a little frail old man. Oh my lord! He thick! Before we hop into this discussion on Zeus, the father of creation, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. Now, let's get into it. What's up guys, Luck of the Pencil here, and here we are to talk about Zeus, the father of creation, aka a really great, a really interesting, a really good character. And like in all of these character videos, I gotta start talking about his design. Alright, so here's the thing. I'm used to Zeus being older, like a man in his late 50s, early 60s, but you know, still tall, muscular built, like has an air of authority to him. That's how Zeus is usually depicted. He's depicted like that in Smite, he's depicted like that in Percy Jackson, he's depicted like that a lot. He's even depicted like that in God of War. He's depicted like that sort of still well-built man all the time in other forms of media, and thusly, I got used to that. So when I first saw Zeus, I was like, what in the world is this shriveled up plum of a thing doing here? I was kind of bamboozled, I'm not even gonna lie, and it got me thinking, like, yo, this isn't how he's gonna fight, right? Like, this isn't what we're going with, is it? Because he looks so frail, he looks so weak. You can see the sunken in eyes, all the wrinkles on his face, everything, the little skinny hair he has on the top. He just seems so pointless and so tiny. Like, how could this man be the father of the cosmos? And then he transforms, and you see that it's almost a facade. And then the design gets even better because of what it ties into Zeus for himself. But regardless of that, I think his initial design, while off-putting, mainly because of the cultural conception of Zeus that formed itself in my mind as Zeus as this sort of regular middle-aged man who, not middle-aged, late-aged man who's still muscular built at all times. Like, despite that, it's still a good design. It conveys his Greek origins very, very well, considering what he's wearing. He has this air of presence to him, and even in his tiny form, later in the mangaka starts drawing him with more muscle definition, so you can still see the aspects of what Zeus really is beneath that. And I think it's a really cool design, and now that I've accepted it fully, I think it's a great, solid design that matches Zeus for what he is as the ancient being he's supposed to be. And then, I think his transcendent state, where he's big, buff, monstrous, I think it's fantastic. One of my favorite moments is when he just transforms into it, and the audience has the exact same reaction I do. Like, this old thing is Zeus, and then he pops some thighs out, and you're like, whoa, bro, them things are gigantic. And I think it just leads into that perfect, it's a very simple yet understandable definition of what the gods are in comparison to humanity. The shot right here, this shot of Zeus looming over Adam is what it is. It's the gods looming over humanity. There are these big imposing creatures to us in terms of raw power, in terms of scale, in terms of ability, and it's great to see that conveyed through Zeus's design. And yeah, it's a lot of muscle, darn near balloons on his arms, whole watermelons for his thighs, but I think it works to convey like the pompous, larger than life nature of the gods. And I think the fact that he maintains the tiny little old man face for the most part is still really, really good, because it still shows that that original Zeus that we know is in there. And it's very important to do that when you're transforming a character, to make sure that at least some of the original initial character is still visible within the new amalgamation that you've created. And the thing is, his final form is oddly terrifying. Like, there's something, it's a strange mix of both forms, because he still has the height and the like overwhelming looming stature of his second form, but he has the slim, toned down nature of his first form. And the thing about it is that the reason it invites such terror is because of how like wrong it feels. He literally crushes down his muscles to the point where they are screaming and steaming to maintain the overwhelming power that exists within him. And it's literally tearing him apart to do this. It's a metal transformation, and I love how every single time, like, when we get a close-up of Zeus, he's steaming, he's releasing. His body isn't made to handle this. This is the limit of his power. Adamas. Diamond. And I wonder, honestly, if that is a callback to his older brother. Like, the only mention of him that could ever exist is a knockoff word that comes from his brother's form, because Adamas and then Adamas. I'm One has an accent, the other doesn't. But regardless, I think that's cool. And I think the form has a great design because it portrays how, like, monstrous the gods really are. Because the second form portrays how overwhelming they are. And the first form portrays how unassuming they could be. While this third form has this, like, monstrous air to it. Where it just carries this presence with it. Where you just feel unsafe. The reason Adam raised his guard for the first time in the entire fight is probably one, because Zeus was releasing overwhelming amounts of power, and two, just because of the intimidation factor that came from this new state, this new appearance, and I like that. And now, into Zeus as a character, and one of the biggest things that I haven't mentioned about him yet, because I wanted to save it for his video here, I love that Zeus aged. If you look at the rest of the gods, they haven't aged. It's been around 4,000 years since the last time they had a Council of Ragnarok, and when you look at all the other gods, none of them really grew any older. Poseidon looks the same, Shiva looks the same, Aphrodite looks the same, all these gods that we know, Ares, every single one of them looks the same. Same thing with Hercules of all people, arguably the most human of all the gods that we have seen so far. Who knows about Buddha? But the thing that makes this so interesting to me is that Zeus aged, and I'm so confident Zeus only aged as a flex. And you may be like, what do I mean? I mean, there's no reason for Zeus to age. If he had stayed in his prime young state, like apparently all the gods can do, remember, Poseidon is older than Zeus. However, it didn't really matter to Poseidon. He still stayed young and in his prime, healthy, like, at best, late 20s, early 30s self. But Zeus aged because he had no fear. Zeus, and that's my favorite thing about Zeus in general, transitioning into this, Zeus has no fear of anything. He believes himself to be the most supreme of supreme. He literally calls himself the GFOC, Godfather of the Cosmos. And to be fair, he earns that title. The Titanomachy was not something that was forced upon Zeus. It was something he chose to do. It wasn't a calamity that came about because of the Titans' rule over creation. It was Zeus himself declaring that he wanted to figure out the hierarchy of creation in terms of power, and thus he did it. He is the one who stomped out Kronos. And one of my favorite things about Zeus is that you can tell that beneath that playful, laughing, smiling exterior is a monster of a man. The disregard for life that he has, the way he walks up to Adam, and when Adam legitimately asks him, hey yo, you may want a weapon, old man, like, I have this brass knuckle here and it's going to hurt, where's yours? And Zeus just goes, man, I just want to feel the feeling of your bones grinding to dust beneath my knuckles. So I'm going barehanded and kisses his knuckle. It's a dark scene, but portrayed in a lighthearted way, because that's what Zeus is. Zeus is a megalomaniac, and at the same time, a fight upset. He's such a strangely interesting character off of his first transition, because you can see how excited he is for Ragnarok. You can see how little he cares that things are dying. Even the only time that we see Zeus ever even particularly worried is when he is forced to use his ultimate state. And that is great. It conveys Zeus as this alpha being, which is what he is. It matches what he is perfectly, and it explains everything perfectly. Do I think his backstory could have been better and more in-depth? Yes. Because while it is cool that it recontextualizes the Titanomachy, it's not enough for me to really be like, yes, this is a great backstory. It just shows us more of what Zeus is. And honestly, I wouldn't rate Zeus that high. He wouldn't be one of my favorites if he just ended after his fight. Because even though I love the ending of that fight, where Zeus falls to his knees, he reverts, he gives up. Because after swinging on Adam endlessly with multiple unavoidable one-hit kills, and that Adam just keeps eating, no problem, he gives up and he straight up admits, I cannot defeat him. He may have died, but I lost this fight of endurance. You have to realize how much that must have hurt Zeus as an individual. Like, he plays it off, but this is a person who, even when challenged by his father, arguably the strongest of the Titans that we know of in Record of Ragnarok, he still just stomped him in and said, whatever, you're done with. He never really gave Kronos any respect outside of his one attack that he stole and took as his own. But he gave Adam the props. And this is where I start to like Zeus as a character much, much more. Because Zeus stops taking humanity as a joke. Even though he beat Adam, which I think is a necessity. I'm as sad as I am that Adam lost, I understand why Adam lost. So I think it's a great ending to that fight. Zeus stops looking at these humans like they're just insignificant creatures. He recognizes the threat that they pose, because if he himself, the strongest god, could be brought to his knees by one of them, and couldn't even make him hit the ground, what could the others do? And what could the people weaker than him do against this overwhelming might that comes with humanity? And you can see it by how he loses all the hype and energy and the vibrato. He's watching the fights with an intense eye, and while he's enjoying them still, because it's what Zeus does, Zeus loves fighting, you can tell he's watching them with a much more concerned air to them. He sends out Poseidon, and Poseidon goes, and when he sees his brother die, there's this look of, not necessarily sadness, but shock. But at the same time, there's this look of understanding, like, oh no, this is happening. It's this great flip where Zeus goes from this almighty, untouchable, inhumane being that couldn't care less about this event to one by one being pounded into the earth and understanding that, oh wait, this is a viable threat. These people are people with the power to challenge us. And the death of Poseidon was what he needed to see that fully. And you can tell by how angry he is when Shiva is about to be like, okay, I gotta go, bro. We cannot let them get any further. You can tell by the way he looks, and he's like, hey, yo, you ain't gonna let Greece repay its debt? And then he sends out Heracles. And what I like about Zeus really a lot in the Heracles fight is that how confident he is in his stepson. Because he, one, considered Heracles enough of a threat to just immediately pull him up with the rest of the guys. He said, hey, yo, leaving you down here, probably gonna be a problem later. You come on with me. I don't like you down here. I think that's cool for Zeus because it shows that he's forethinking, which honestly I didn't really think much of. But then also on top of that, it shows that Zeus does have faith in people. Like you would think with how powerful he is and how little he cares for life, at least how little we'd seen he cared for life beforehand, he wouldn't have stopped Ares from crying that Hercules lost his arm. It would have been like, tough noogies, better figure it out. But however, he shows that faith in Heracles that makes me like him a whole lot more. It shows that somewhere within that combat crazy monster is a guy who has faith, a guy who does believe, a person. And I think that's very important for characterizing someone and giving them realistic layers. And you can tell by how angry he is that he actually legitimately cared for Heracles, something that honestly you didn't even see for his own older brother. And it's good stuff. It's good to make Zeus this more shackled down, serious person that we can actually understand. Do we know why Zeus is this crazy combat loving fiend? No, but we can understand why. We can see that through his power, through his stance as the most superior being in all of creation, that of course he looks down on the rest of it. Of course he wants to do it. And another thing that I love so much about Zeus is that he just doesn't care. Like, he cares to certain degrees with certain situations. Like, he cares about Record of Ragnarok. He cares about the different gods that could possibly die. Like, he cares about the reputation of Greece, obviously. But at the same time, he's also willing to let things like Ragnarok happen. He's willing to let things like Adamas' rebellion happen. He knew they were going to happen. He didn't care, though. He was down for it. He was down for Adamas' rebellion, a war. He was like, hey, yo, it's time, B, let's go get it. And then for Record of Ragnarok, he was so happy to slam that hammer down after he murdered that dragon. So I think it's great to see this. Zeus is a two-sided character with multiple faces. And Zeus is like a die. That's it. Zeus is like a die. Because you can see all these things, all these multiple faces are tied to one being. Zeus, the combat monster, is the same Zeus that cares about the reputation of Greece, and is the same Zeus that cares about his stepson, and is the same Zeus that couldn't care less about humanity, that grows to care about humanity in the sense that he fears them. All these different parts of Zeus roll together and have meshed together so well to create such a complete character that I really, really enjoy. And I like how Zeus is shown to care a bit about order, because not only does he run the Council of the Gods, but you can see when Buddha goes to rebel, Zeus is like, hey yo, you need to stop. Like, the serious nature that comes with Zeus in that moment, it reinforces his position. Like, once again, he's in his tiny form, but yeah, he is the leader of all the gods, the godfather of the cosmos. And he is a nice guy still, to a degree. He laughs with Buddha, but he still threatens him. He's like, hey yo, don't do that again. And it's, the reason I like Zeus so much is because he has so many different parts of him, all of which individually I enjoy, but wrapped together into one singular character, I really, really, really like. Because it's just great. Like, I've nothing else to really say. It's just the fact that Zeus is such a completed character. And honestly, I can't wait to see more of him. I'm glad he's alive, because we got more of the Zeus that I was interested in seeing. If Zeus had died in his fight with Adam, I would have been like, eh, he's a decent character. But seeing all this, seeing all more of this, is what makes me seriously enjoy Zeus. And yeah, I think that's about it. Because is there anything else I really want to touch on with Zeus in particular? I think not. The only thing I'm disappointed with is that Zeus doesn't have any electricity powers. I don't know. I understand why, because you have Thor there, and you gotta give Thor the electricity powers. But man, I like Zeus, God of Lightning. Man, I wish we had that. Other than that, yeah, Zeus is just all around a really fully formed character. Tell me what you guys think about Zeus in the comment section down below. Would you change anything? Because really, the only thing I would change about Zeus is give him a better, longer backstory. Because especially to compare it to someone like Adam, which really, really does great things for Adam as a character. Zeus's backstory doesn't do much for him except more thoroughly establish who he is. And I think I just want to see him fight again. That's really all I really desire when it comes to Zeus. But tell me what you guys think in the comment section down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And I hope you guys have a wonderful day. This is That Guy with the Pencil, writing off.